Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a compelling tri-portrait design of a face. Open a photo of a face that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. If you're not a subscriber to my channel, hit that small subscribe button at the lower right corner. The first step is to check its size and resolution. To do this, go to Image and Image Size. Its size and resolution will probably need to be increased to give us the best result if we decide to print it at some point. I'll make its width and height approximately 4400 pixels and its resolution 300 pixels per inch. For yours, feel free to adjust its size, however, make sure its resolution is 300 pixels per inch. We need to separate our subject from its background by making a selection around our subject. There are many ways to do this, however, for this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. If you're using this tool as well, I find that a radius of 10 pixels generally works fine on most images. Drag the tool over the inside of your subject to make a selection of its shape. If you need to remove areas outside of your subject, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. To check it, press Q on your keyboard to see it as a quick mask. To refine its edges, press Q again to revert it back into a selection, and go to Select. If you're using a recent version of Photoshop, click Select and Mask. However, if you're using an earlier version, click Refine Edge. To open Refine Edge on a recent version, Shift-click Select and Mask. I did in-depth tutorials on both Refine Edge and Select and Mask, so if you'd like to watch them, I provided their links in my video's description, which is below the title of the video. Check Smart Radius and drag your tool over the soft or feathery edges of your subject. Output it as a new layer with Layer Mask. Control-click or Command-click the layer mask to make a selection of its shape. Press Q to see it as a quick mask. Go to View, and if Rulers isn't checked, click it to open it. Go to the ruler on the left and drag out a guideline to the center of your subject. If you don't see the guideline, press Control or Command H. Go to the top ruler and drag down a guideline to the neck. Press P to open your pen tool and click on the middle guideline approximately here on your subject. Release and then click approximately here. Release again and continue to make a shape that extends outside your document. When you've closed the path, place your pen directly on the path and right-click your mouse or pen to open the menu. Click Make Selection and make sure the radius is 0 pixels. Make sure your foreground and background colors are black and white respectively, so black is your foreground color. If it isn't, press D on your keyboard. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the selection. Go to Select and Transform Selection. Go to Edit, Transform, and Flip Horizontal. Go inside the selection and press and hold Shift as you drag it across to the left until it's flush with the other shape. Press Enter or Return to accept the transform. Fill the selection and then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Hide the guidelines by pressing Ctrl or Command H. Press Q to make it into a selection. Drag the layer mask to the trash and click the layer mask icon to make the selection into a new layer mask. We'll convert our visible image into a smart object so we can add filters to it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right corner and click Convert to Smart Object. Create a new document by going to File and New. Make its width 14.5 inches, its height 15.5 inches, and its resolution 300 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. The background content is white. Then click Create or Open. Open back your subject and press V to open your Move tool. Drag your subject onto the tab of your new document. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. We'll adjust its size and position in a minute. For now, hide the face layer and click the lock icon to unlock the background. Click the foreground color and in the hexadecimal field, type in B2870A. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill it with a color. We'll use this color for now. Near the end of this video, I'll show you how to quickly change the color of the background. Double-click the background to open its layer style window. Click Gradient Overlay and the Gradient Bar. Click the black-white thumbnail and click OK. Change the blend mode to screen. The opacity is 100% and check reverse. Make the style radial, the angle 90 degrees, and the scale 150%. Click Inner Glow and the color box. Pick white and click OK. The blend mode is normal and the opacity is 100%. The source is edge, the choke is 100%, and the size is 205 pixels. Click stroke and the color box. Type in 312628. Make the size 152 pixels and the position is inside. To save space in the Layers panel, click the small arrow to collapse the effects. Make the face visible again and active. To adjust its size, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. To reposition it, go inside the Transform's bounding box and drag it. Then press Enter or Return. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and click Graphic Pen. The stroke length is 15, the light-dark balance is 50, and the stroke direction is right diagonal. To save space, let's collapse the filter effect. Make a copy of the face by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Hide the bottom face and double-click an empty area of the top face layer to open its layer style window. Under Advanced Blending, notice that all three channels are checked, red, green, and blue. For this face, uncheck the blue channel. Collapse the filter and make the bottom face visible. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. For this face, uncheck the green channel. Presently, the face doesn't look different than it did from the start. However, once we reposition it, you'll immediately see the channel effect. For this design, we'll decrease the sizes of the other two face layers. To do this, open your Transform tool. If you see this message, it's just letting us know that the smart filter that we added to the face will be temporarily turned off while we use the Transform tool. Just click OK. At the top, click the chain link icon between the width and the height. This links them together, so whatever percentage we type into one will be automatically repeated in the other. In either field, Type in 80%. Drag it to the right and align the right side of the bottom triangular shape to the bottom side of the other face. Then press Enter or Return. Collapse the filter and make a copy of it. Make the bottom face layer active and drag it to the left, aligning the left side of the triangular bottom shape to the bottom shape of the middle face. Double-click an empty area of the bottom face layer to open the layer style window. Check the green channel and uncheck the red channel. We're ready to add our text. Scroll to the top of the Layers panel and make the top layer active. We'll place our text above it. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer and change its blend mode to Difference. This will make our text stand out more when it overlaps our portrait. Invert the foreground and background colors by clicking this double arrow icon. Now, white is your foreground color. Open your horizontal type tool and type picker. Pick a font you like. I'm using Legal Tender. If you'd like to use it as well, I provided its link in my video's description or project files. I'll make its size 83 points, but feel free to use whatever size you like. I'll make its aliasing sharp and center alignment. Click on the document and type out your text. To center it, open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A to select your document and click the Align Horizontal Centers icon. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. To slide your text up or down, press the up or down arrow on your keyboard. Next, we'll add a subtle paper-like texture to our design. Make a new layer and fill it with white. Change its blend mode to Linear Burn. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Close the Sketch folder and open the Texture folder. Click Texturizer. Make the texture sandstone, the scaling 200%, the relief 5, and the light from the top left. Lastly, I'll show you how to quickly change your background's color. Scroll to the bottom and make the solid color layer active. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Drag the hue slider to the left or right until you like the colors of your background. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.